So what's going on here today?
Well, we have our opening day for all Ferndale staff. We wanted to do something different and special, so we brought all the staff from everywhere in the district. So we had a breakfast provided by the school board and by community and by PTA. So all the teachers and staff and everyone can see how important they are to the community and everybody. So we're going to be doing a little bit of motivational talk and kind of looking at our vision of the year within the auditorium. And then we have professional development for teachers in many, many different areas put on by mostly our staff, because we have a phenomenal staff. And so we have different teachers that are experts in different areas. Like, for example, our keynote speaker is one of our teachers who gives motivational speeches all over the metro area. And so it's a resource that we really underutilize. So that's kind of what we're looking at for today.
Nice. And what is your vision now that school is getting ready to start?
You'll start seeing a new tagline with the district, as well as a new logo, which is on the shirt here. The tagline is Dignity, Diversity, and Dreams. And it's really about the dignity of every child. It's about the diversity of our education, diversity of our students, and the dreams of our students. How do we help them find a dream, and how do we help them live a dream? And that's what we're going to be about this year.
Good, thank you.
My name is Nick Sages, and I am an ACM at the Digital Learning Center.
What does the ACM mean?
Academic Case Manager.
Okay, great. And can you explain what that is for people that don't know?
The Digital Learning Center is Ferndale's non-traditional educational setting, where students work both on-site and at home via the internet and curriculum that we have developed within the school district that may aid them in their academic progress.
And how long have you been with the district for?
8 years.
And how long have you been teaching?
I've been in education for 16.
Do you have any advice for teachers who are kind of new this year?
The advice I would have is ask for help. If you need anything, look to your fellow teachers for any type of advice, any kind of guidance, whether it's dealing with anything academically or anything with parents, students, or even administration. Everybody's here to work together, so I think that's important.
My name is Camille Gunter. I work at the Grant Early Childhood Center. I'm a Head Start teacher.
And how long have you been a teacher for?
I've been a teacher for 7 years.
And what is your favorite thing about teaching?
My favorite thing about teaching is probably the hug from the kids, having fun with the children, and just coming to work every day.
Ryan Dunlap, I teach science at Ferndale High School.
And how long have you been a teacher for?
15 years.
Do you have any advice for teachers who are just starting out?
For new teachers, I would suggest being prepared to work very hard, long hours after school, before school, and to find time to remember why you chose to be a teacher, and sign up for us to be difficult at times with the number of hours you put in, but teaching is a great career, and if you keep working at it, things do get a little bit easier as it goes on.
And why did you decide to become a teacher?
I love science, and I love working with high school age students. I've coached for a long time as well, so that was a part of it. And I just think that the way I operate kind of fit all together. It's been a good career choice for me.
My name is Teresa Harvey, and I'm currently a literacy specialist for grades 4 through 6.
And how long have you been teaching for?
This will be my 9th year.
And why did you decide to get involved with teaching?
I decided to be a teacher, I think because my role models when I was younger were all teachers. I always looked up to them and admired them, and since I can remember, I've always wanted to be a teacher. I didn't get into it initially, though. When I graduated from high school and went on to college, I got into financial business, but something kept pulling me back, telling me that that's what I was meant to do, so I went back to school and became a teacher.
My name is Scott Jeffrey. I teach world history, 7th grade at Ferndale Middle School. It's my 15th year in the district, my 16th year teaching, so I'm really excited to start what I hope is my halfway point to the future.
Very nice, very nice. So why did you decide to become a teacher?
That's an easy question for me to answer. I love kids, and for me, I'm a graduate of Ferndale Public Schools, so I had a lot of teachers that influenced me, made my life better, helped me get to where I wanted to be, achieve goals that I didn't think I was going to achieve, and it's kind of my way of paying it forward, I guess.
My name is Connie Senecal, and I teach the Michigan School of Readiness Program at Grant Early Childhood Building.
What is that program?
It's a grant program through Michigan State, and it consists of a preschool program. It's an all-day program for students from 8:30 in the morning till 3:30 in the afternoon. It's free for those families that qualify for our program.
Nice. And how long have you been at Grant for?
I have been with this program for 25 years.
Wow. And so what, is there anything exciting about going back to school? What do you enjoy about it?
Oh, I love the students. I love the children. It's always so exciting to get a whole new group of children and see the excitement on their faces, and I'm looking so forward to it.
My name is Blake Pruitt. I am your new superintendent this year. It is a pleasure to be here with you all this day. It is great to see everyone alive and awake. As I told the freshmen when I was in here last week, I think that was the earliest they've woken up since they left school, and I'm sure for some of us when the alarm clock went off this morning, we went, really? Back at it? Okay. So first off, thank you for being here. I would like to thank the school board and all the community members and the PTAs for the fantastic breakfast this morning. So what's our one sentence as educators? How does this help student achievement? Now the thing I don't define here is what achievement means. So I'm sure each and every one of us, it means something different, depending on what you teach, what you do, what your background is. In education, we're really good at having 8,000 things out there we have to pay attention to. And we know the state is great at moving the bar each and every day, considering that, you know, we know our test this year, the test formerly known as the MEEP and now currently known as the MEEP. You know, and Lord knows what questions are going to be on this mythical MEEP. You know, it's sort of like the land of unicorns and rainbows right now. So what does this mean to us? And I'm sure it's more than what, per se, the state test. And as things throughout the year and throughout your career get muddled, and all these different things get thrown at you, I'm sure those of you who've been in education more than 15 years can give me a whole list of different programs that have come and gone. Because in education, we know the mantra is if you wait 2 years, it'll go away. What is really important? What is really important to what we do? So we try to answer this, and what is Ferndale about? What's this year about? We took down the three words, dignity, diversity, and dreams. And what does that mean for us as Ferndale Schools? In dignity, yes, it's about every child. It's the dignity of every child. It's the dignity of every person. But it's about modeling. You know from growing up that the adults that you had in your life, you either learned the right way to act or the wrong way to act. But we know being in education, we want students to learn from us in the right way we act. We want them to model our good behavior. It's the way we treat each other. It's the way we believe in each other. It is so easy to give up belief in a kid. I ran into one of my former students a couple months ago, and she was one of these students that, honestly, I didn't know if she was going to be alive in 4 years. And she went through a rough patch, but now she's going to community college. She's getting a degree in mechatronics, she has a job. She was always an intelligent girl. And I sat there and I listened to her, and she talked to me about the teachers that believed in her and about why she felt that she could do this. But then she also talked to me about the teachers and ministers and people that didn't believe in her. And I sat there and thought to myself, did I believe in her? Or did I give up on her? And I really debated with myself, because I really did struggle with her, because as an assistant principal, she was in my office all the time. She was one of the frequent flyers. But we have to believe. We have to have the dignity of kids, and we have to believe in each other. And what about diversity? Diversity can mean many, many things. I keep on hearing how it's the strength of our school district, it's the strength of our community. Yet do we really know what that means? Do we explore what that means? And it's much more than socioeconomic, race. It's many, many different things. It's the diversity of our education. The days of working the job for 30 years in the same place is gone. The average adult has 7 different careers. The average, I think, college student changes majors 5 to 6 times. It's a very, very different world than when many of us graduated high school. So education has to be different. It has to be diverse. Students have to learn a lot more. They have to critically think. They have to problem solve. They have to be able to live in the 21st century. And what about the dreams? You know, I used the term achievement before, and you'll see in almost every tagline in every school district will say achievement somewhere. If any of you have been through any DeFore's work, he can tell you in about 3 minutes, he can give you every mission statement of every school district in the United States. 21st century education, something about technology, something about achievement, something about future for all. So I started thinking, what does it mean for us? When every student walks across the stage with a diploma, when every student moves forward each year, I'd like them to have a dream. What do they want to be? What do they dream they can be? And then how do we help them get there? When I was in the gym earlier this week with Mr. Butler, we had a group of freshmen for freshman orientation, and I asked the kids, what do you want to be 10 years from now? Maybe half the hands went up. And I sat there, and what about the half that doesn't know? What about the half that's going, I'm just trying to get through today to get through tomorrow? How do we help them find a path? And how do we help them get there? We know our school model has been the industrial model, and we're always trying to adapt it for the world that we live in. You know, when you have a little kindergartner, don't you want 12 years for them to have a path and to know what they're going to do? And for them to go, starting back even kindergarten, that helped me be able to live what I want my dream to be. And we know kids, their dreams change, we know they get off track, but how do we help that move forward? So it's a new day at Ferndale Schools. As we go into this year, I want you to refocus, continue to refocus. Why are you here? What are we about? When things get frustrating, when you get upset, because it will happen. You know, wherever two or more are gathered, there's going to be a problem. So there's going to be issues. But why are we here? And let's call each other to accountability why we're here when we get off track.